I'm Garrett Lifweiss.
And welcome to this year's first SVSN news broadcast.
Us Piketon Metrics were very busy this week.
To start off the week, students participated in the annual Spirit Week. Streaks came to school dressed up with a different theme for each day. Our field reporter, Tetiana Nuaeva, covered this week's events.
Thank you, Molly. Here's a recap of the winners of Spirit Week.
On Monday, we had Magic Monday. Students were supposed to dress as fairies, witches, or anything else magical. On Tuesday, we had Too Tired Tuesday. Students were supposed to wear pajamas or what they wear to bed. On Wednesday, we had Wonderful Wednesday. Students were supposed to dress up for picture day. On Thursday, we had Twin Thursday. Students were supposed to twin with another student or group. On Friday, we had Farm Friday. Students were dressed as farmers or farm animals. Back to you, Molly and Garrett.
Thanks, Tetiana.
This past weekend, Piketon students and their dates attended the annual football homecoming dance. SVSN field reporters Sarah Gilman and Alex Waddle covered this evening's festivities. Out to you, Sarah and Alex.
Thank you, Molly and Garrett.
Last weekend, students, parents, and teachers celebrated homecoming 2015. Students and parents alike braved the cold and rainy weather on the start of an unfortunately dreary day. Many students went to the Big Beaver Creek Golf Course on Zahn's Corner Road to take pictures before the big night.
With its lush rolling hills and beautiful scenery, the course is the perfect backdrop for pictures. The dance was held to celebrate the famous homecoming game and the start of a new school year.
As all high school students were allowed to attend, this was the first dance for many. The dance was held at the Old Piketon High School on Saturday, September 26, 2015.
It lasted from 8 to 11 p.m. with a $5 admission fee. The night was filled with dancing music and fantastic lighting.
There was a wide range of songs played, such as Bad Blood, God Gave Me You, The Cupid Shuffle, Hey Mama, and even the Chicken Dance. Food and drinks were sold at the concession stand.
Back to you, Molly and Garrett.
Thank you, Alex and Sarah. Now to introduce this year's first special segment, Brunch with B-Dad.
Let's take it out to SVSN's very own B-Daddy.
Hey everybody, this is my new segment, Brunch with B-Dad. Jay Willie's here with me today. And today we're going to talk about waffles. Waffles, they are very good. It's a great breakfast meal, great lunch meal, great dinner meal. I like to eat mine with bacon, sausage, and eggs. But my favorite part is the syrup. What do you think, Jay Will?
Well, you know, I'm a big fan of waffles myself because there's many ways to make waffles. You can take the frozen waffles and put them in a toaster, which are always good. You can make them out of batter. Now, one of my favorite experiences is to go to the Waffle House. What do you think about the Waffle House?
The Waffle House is great.
It really is.
Best place on earth.
I once went to a Waffle House with Mr. Clinker outside of Gettysburg, of all places. So, very historical waffles there.
Well, here's a fact about the Waffle House, actually. 550 million waffles have been served since 1955. That's a lot of waffles, folks.
Tremendous amount of waffles.
Yeah, and I'm glad to say I ate about two of them. How many have you ate there?
I've probably had about four waffles in my lifetime from the Waffle House.
Well, waffles are great.
They are.
Love them. Syrup especially.
It's a little sticky, but it's still good.
Yeah, I mean, blueberry syrup, and strawberries, all those good syrups.
It's all good. I agree.
Well, that's it, everybody. Thanks for tuning in to the first episode of Brunch with B-Dad. And thank you, Jay Will, for coming.
Thank you for having me.
Thanks, B-Daddy.
Now let's take it off to the Sports Center team.
Welcome to the very first episode of Scioto Valley Sports News. Your anchor here, Bradley Sickles.
And your other anchor, Gabe Berkheimer. Our goal is to report only the most tasty and exhilarating sports news.
Yes, the most tastiest and exhilarating indeed. Like last Wednesday, our Piketon High School girls took part in a friendly Powder Puff football game.
The mighty sophomores and juniors took on the fearsome freshmen and seniors. Our field reporter Donald has more on the story. Out to you, Donald.
Hi, thanks, Parkland with SVSN News. I have
Cameron Chilwood, head coach and offensive coordinator.
And I also have
defensive coordinator Matt Smith.
I'm here to ask you guys a couple of questions about the Powder Puff football game you're going to have Wednesday 23rd at the Pike County Stadium. What's your defensive strategy, Matt Smith?
Well, our DB is just going to dominate. And our linebacker is going to take the ball, and Devin's probably not going to be able to do anything. So he's pretty much done.
Sounds like you have the game planned out and ready. How long have you been coaching, Cameron Chilwood?
2 weeks.
Oh, that's been a while for you. What about you, Matt Smith?
Same.
Oh, good, good. What's the most important thing you teach your team, Cameron?
When?
When? And you, Matt?
Fundamentals. That's the core of football.
What do you mean by that?
Fundamentals? Everything. Everything, Hank.
Do you see yourself coaching in the future?
You never know what the future holds. You never know.
You have a point. And you, Cameron?
No.
Okay. How do you predict the end of the game?
It's just going to be a domination. We'll win.
Okay, and you, Cameron?
Win.
Okay, now back to you.
Thank you, Donald, for the report over the Powerpuff football game. Now out to Andrew Thompson for a review of the homecoming game.
September 25th was Piketon's homecoming game. To start things off, Sammy Grooms won the 2015 Homecoming Queen. The first quarter, unfortunately, was not very good for the Streaks. The Warriors were up 28-0 on two rushing touchdowns, a passing touchdown, and a pick six. Later in the game, Piketon's own Gabe Berkheimer scored on a 57-yard touchdown thrown by Devin Brewster. Adina would score again before the half. In the third quarter, Piketon would catch some momentum with Gabe Berkheimer scoring again with the help of his QB. Adina, though, would score two more times before the game was over. Even though things did not go as planned for the Streaks, they are confident they will bounce back with a great game versus Westfall.
Good job, Andrew, on that report over the homecoming game. Well, that is it for this episode of SVSN. And to all of you out there in the Valley, keep it classy.